The Aquarian Gospel of Jesus the Christ. Section 5. Hey, Childhood and Early Education of Jesus. Chapter 16. The Home of Joseph. Mary teaches her son. Jesus' grandparents give a feast in his honor. Jesus has a dream. His grandmother interpretation. His birthday gift. The home of Joseph was on Miriam Way in Nazareth. Here Mary taught her son the lessons of Elihu and Salome. And Jesus greatly loved the Vedic hymns and the Avestas, but more than all he loved to read the Psalms of David and the pungent words of Solomon. The Jewish books of prophecy were his delight, and when he reached his seventh year, he needed not the books to read, for he had fixed in memory every word. Joachim and his wife, grandparents of child Jesus, made a feast in honor of the child, and all their near of kin were guests. And Jesus stood before the guests and said, I had a dream, and in my dream I stood before a sea, upon a sandy beach. The waves upon the sea were high. A storm was raging on the deep. Someone above gave me a wand. I took the wand and touched the sand, and every grain of sand became a living thing. The beach was all a mass of beauty and of song. I touched the waters at my feet, and they were changed to trees and flowers and singing birds, and everything was praising God. And someone spoke. I did not see the one who spoke. I heard the voice, which said, There is no death. Grandmother Anna loved the child. She laid her hand on Jesus' head and said, I saw you stand beside the sea. I saw you touch the sand and waves. I saw them turn to living things, and then I knew the meaning of the dream. The sea of life rolls high. The storms are great. The multitude of men are idle, listless, waiting, like dead sand upon the beach. Your wand is truth. With this you touch the multitudes, and every man becomes a messenger of holy light and life. You touch the waves upon the sea of life. Their turmoil cease. The very winds become a song of praise. There is no death, because the wand of truth can change the driest bones to living things, and bring the loveliest flowers from stagnant ponds, and turn the most discordant notes to harmony and praise. Joachim said, My son, today you pass the seventh milestone of your way of life, for you are 7 years of age, and we will give to you, as a remembrance of this day, whatever you desire. Choose that which will afford you most delight. And Jesus said, I do not want a gift, for I am satisfied. If I could make a multitude of children glad upon this day, I would be most greatly pleased. Now, there are many hungry boys and girls in Nazareth, who would be pleased to eat with us this feast and share with us the pleasures of this day. The richest gift that you can give to me is your permission to go out and find these needy ones and bring them here that they may feast with us. Joachim said, 'Tis well. Go out and find the needy boys and girls and bring them here. We will prepare enough for all. And Jesus did not wait. He ran. He entered every dingy hut and cabin of the town. He did not waste his words. He told his mission everywhere. And in a little time, 103 of happy, raged boys and girls were following him up Miriam Way. The guests made way. The banquet hall was filled with Jesus' guests. And Jesus and his mother helped to serve, and there was food enough for all, and all were glad, and so the birthday gift of Jesus was a crown of righteousness.